Oh wow, it's just so good to be with you again. Good to see you soon. And every time I come to see someone I haven't seen for a long time, which is really nice. Great to see Penny. Where's Penny? Penny was here. Becky is there. Great to see you, Penny. I've done a long time again since I've seen you. So it's wonderful to be back and wonderful to see familiar faces. And so because you're familiar, you can all smile at me. Could you help me? I say I always preach quicker. Okay, the more you smile, the more you interact. Okay, it all belongs to that. But I want to bring something. Just before we do, the conference, we've got the Arise Conference at our church, which we do two Arise conferences every year. And it's great to have Andrew with us this year. It's hard to get Andrew, you know. He hardly ever travels as much as he used to. So it's a great privilege. We've been trying to get him for 2 years. And so he's coming over, Ted Hansen, who we don't have. I want to encourage you, sometimes it's just nice to get away. From your surroundings and familiar surroundings, and come away, come aside. And you know, it's those times usually when God really speaks into your life. It's a prophetic conference. We want to hear what God wants to say. So I want to encourage as many to come. It's a long way, I know, in Manchester from here. But you know, many can come. Please do come. It's going to be an amazing time, a powerful time together. Amen. Okay, I want to look in the scriptures in the book of Matthew. And I want to read a few verses from the book of Matthew and apply it to our lives and to our situations and stuff that we all go through in life. Who knows, you go through so much stuff in life. And we can apply the scriptures and to our lives, and we're going to look at that in a few moments. So if you look in Matthew chapter 14, the scripture... Matthew chapter 14. I didn't put it on the slide, but it's so small, isn't it, John? I don't think you'd probably be able to read it. Yeah, I'm just going to read the scripture. But you're okay. So John chapter, in Matthew chapter 14, verse 22. So it's Matthew 14 and 22. Let me read a few verses. Immediately after this, Jesus insisted that his disciples get back into the boat and cross to the other side of the lake. By the way, I want you to know something. God is always taking you somewhere.
Yes.
He always wants to take you somewhere. Wants to take you from where you are to another level, to another place.
Yes.
Wants to take his church, which is, actually, I love coming here. But he wants to take his church to another level, to another place, like he does with our church as well. So, to the other side of the lake. And while he sent the people home, after sending them home, he went up into the hills by himself to pray. Night fell though while they were there. Meanwhile, the disciples were in trouble far away from the land, for a strong wind had risen and they were fighting heavy winds. I'm reading from the New Living Translation. About 3 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came towards them walking on the water. Wow, that must have been amazing. And when the disciples saw him walking on the water, they were terrified. In their fear, they cried out, "What is it? Is it a ghost?" But Jesus spoke to them at once. "Do not be afraid," he said. "Take courage. I am here." Then Peter called to him, "Lord, if it's really you, tell me to come to you walking on the water." "Yes, come," Jesus said. So Peter went over the side of the boat and walked on the water towards Jesus. Wow, that is supernatural. Wow. But when he saw the strong wind and the waves, he was terrified and he began to sink. "Save me, Lord," he shouted. Jesus immediately reached out. He grabbed him. "You have so little faith," Jesus said. "Why did you doubt me?" When they climbed back into the boat, the wind stopped. Then Jesus' disciples worshipped him. "You really are the Son of God," they exclaimed. Wow! What a great story! What a great story of adventure and faith. And you see, Jesus with the disciples, you'll often hear him say, "You have little faith." What he's trying to do, he's trying to develop their faith. He's trying trying to develop their believing. And you know, it's just like you and me. God wants to develop our faith. I don't know about you, but does anyone can tell me what the five senses are? The five senses.
Sight.
So someone said touch. You said touch. The back. Anyone else? Sight.
Smell.
Hearing. Have we lost one? We've got one more. Feeling.
Taste.
Right. These are so important, and with our five senses, we can know the world around us. We can get to grips with what's happening in the world around us because of the senses that God has given us in our natural bodies. But I want to talk about another sense that God gives us, which is at a higher level, which not only helps us to see and understand the reality of what's around us in the natural realm, it helps us to tap in to the supernatural realm. And that is this, it's a sense of faith. Because as believers, God wants to develop our faith. He wants to grow our faith in Him. Everyone say amen. Anyway, He wants you to grow. He wants you to develop. Thank God that when you're a Christian, He saves us. But thank God, He doesn't want to keep us where we are when we first get saved. But there is a development, there is a growing in our lives that God wants us to understand who God is and how we can work with God in our lives. So I want to talk about this faith this morning. And I want to look at the development of the disciples' faith. This story. My wife was speaking at a women's conference not long ago. She used the same story, and her points were so much better than mine. I mean, they really were. You spoke about going from fear to freedom, you know, focus on. So I'm just going to use a few points in this story and to help us about how we can walk in faith. Who would say with me, Pastor, I need to walk in greater faith?
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I need to walk in greater faith. I know there's much more than what I'm experiencing now in my walk with God. That if I can only develop my faith, if I can only develop my believing, because Jesus said all things are possible to him who believes. Wow. So this story helps us. Number one, I want to look at the first point I want to put up there is. The first thing that happened we see is that Peter, to see this incredible miracle, to Peter to walk with faith, he had to act on the word of God. In other words, he had to respond to what Jesus was saying. I want you to know something this morning. When we begin to act on the word of God, when we begin to respond in our lives to what God is telling us, I want to tell you, it's so powerful. Now the Bible says, him who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. So he wants us to be hearing what he says. Yeah. And that's the first step, really. We've got to hear what God said. But we've got to go beyond hearing. We've got to start acting on what he said. We've got to start responding to the words of Jesus in order for us to grow in our faith. And we see in this story that Peter, the disciples, are so fearful and they go from fear to faith. They go on a journey with Jesus into the supernatural, into a life of faith. You see, someone once said about this story that Peter didn't really walk on the water, but Peter walked on the word. Let me explain that. Remember the story, Peter's there. He says, Lord, if it be you, ask me to come. Jesus, I want to be. Peter's saying this. Peter's saying, Jesus, I want to be where you are. I want to live like you live. I want to live in this dimension that you're living in. So Peter, Jesus says to Peter, come. One word. Just one word, come. And Peter begins to act on that word, come, and begins to live a life of the supernatural. He goes from fear to faith because he responds to the word of God. You see, not only did Peter walk on the water, he was walking on the words that Jesus spoke to him. I want to tell you, folks, we've got to walk on the word of God. The Bible says that we have so many promises. All the promises of God are what they are, yes and amen in Christ. We can walk on the words of Jesus. We can walk on the words of God. And when we begin to respond to the words of God like Peter did, I want to tell you, your life will never be the same again. Because you begin to cultivate a habit of walking with God and walking in faith. And when you walk in faith, let me tell you, all fear will go. How many of us fear? How many of us just like disciples? Jesus, I know you want me to go further. I know you're taking me on a journey. But God, I'd rather stay here. No, God wants you to grow. He wants you to develop your faith. Amen. So the first one is we've got to act on the words of Jesus. The second thing is this, number two. Second thing we've got to do, we've got to see Jesus in the storm. What do I mean by that? Well, I don't know if you've ever been in a storm.
Oh, yes.
Anyone?
Oh,
yes. Anyone, hey, by the way, let me just ask you, anyone going through a storm right now?
Oh, yes.
I want to tell you, in your life, you've either just come out of a storm, okay, or you're in a storm. Two things. You've either just come out of one or you're in one. In life, we will have so much trouble, like Pastor John has said. So much trouble will come, so many storms will come into our lives. I don't know what storm you are facing right now. I don't know what situation you are going through right now in your life. But I want you to know something. That you can see Jesus in your storm. You can see Jesus in the midst of your storm. You see, storms happen when you least expect that. Wouldn't it be great if you could, you know, if you get a text message, John, at 9:30 on Tuesday morning, a storm's coming, just prepare yourself.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be great? But who knows, because life doesn't work like that. Life doesn't happen like that. Storms just happen. They can come out of the blue and they just happen straight away. And you're very unprepared when a storm comes.
Yeah.
Just unprepared. You think, my goodness, where did that come from?
What happened?
And suddenly, you're in the midst of a storm. I don't know what storm you may be going through this morning. It could be a family storm. Anyone ever had a family storm?
Yeah.
A physical storm when you're struggling with your health, a financial storm. It could be so many different things in our lives, but every one of us find ourselves sometimes in a storm. I love the story in Mark chapter 4, and I won't go there for time, but Jesus is in the boat with his disciples, and again they're crossing over a lake, and it's a great story because we find out that Jesus is actually asleep in the boat when there's a storm. Can you imagine that? And the disciples are like, Jesus, don't you care? Are you bothered? Can't you see what's happening all around us? And Jesus is that's a miracle in itself. You can be asleep in the storm. Yeah. But here's what Jesus did. The Bible says that Jesus got up, and this is what he did. He spoke to the wind and to the waves. And here's what he said. Peace, be still. And here's what Jesus did. He spoke into the storm. Yeah. Amen? He spoke into the storm. And when he spoke into the storm, they found the peace of God. Jesus calmed the storm. I want to tell you today, this morning, that Jesus can calm the storms in your life.
Yes.
Just by one word. Peace. Be still. Now, here's it. If you're like me, sometimes the storm can be going on around us. But when God speaks a word of peace into your heart, He can still the storms inside. And often He needs to speak those words into your heart to still the storm inside of your heart before He stills the storm around you. So whatever happened around you, you can know the peace of God. The Bible says this, it passes our understanding. It passes our understanding. We can't work it out. But it's the peace of God. So I'm here to tell you that even in the midst of your storm right now, all hell might be breaking loose, but He can speak a word of peace. And He can speak peace into your life. And He can calm the storm that rages inside. Say, oh, Pastor, that's me this morning. Who needs that for themselves this morning? Sometimes I need Jesus just to still the storm in my life. I want to tell you, He's the master of the storms. Peace be still. We've got to see Jesus in our storms. I don't know what storm you may go into, but I know if you look for Jesus, He'll be there. And He'll speak a word. And He'll calm the storm in your life. Amen. Here's the third thing. They responded to His word today. You've got to see Jesus in the storm. You've got to walk by faith. No, it really says they had to step out of the boat. They had to step out of their boat. I want to tell you, hear me, church. We get so comfortable. Who's got a favourite pair of slippers that you put on when you go home? And no other pair feels like that pair of slippers. They're so cosy. And we get used, we feel, get so comfy in our life. But you know what? Sometimes Jesus stirs the pool. He stirs the waters. And He stirs the waters in our life so that we will move forward in our faith. You see, sometimes the storms of life come to us to move us forward in our faith with Him. Amen? And so He stirs the waters. He stirs the pool, and He's got to get us out of the boat, out of our own security, out of our own comfort, into trusting in Him, trusting in God. I want you to know something. God wants you to trust in Him with all of your heart. But sometimes you've got to get out of the boat. Peter had to get out of his familiar surroundings. A fisherman. He knew the boat. But Jesus was calling him out of the boat. And I want you to know something. That God calls us out of our comfort zones in order to meet with Him and to walk by faith and not by sight. He wants to be a man and woman of faith. Sometimes we've got to get out of the boat. We've got to trust God and do something. Thank God this church is here, because John said, I've got to get out of the boat. Amen. I've got to take a step of faith. Step of faith. Plan this church, and now look at it, it's great, there's people here worshipping God. I want to tell you, it takes someone's faith to say, I'm going to do something that might make me uncomfortable, but I'm going to do it because God is calling me to get out of the boat. I don't know what boat you're in this morning, what it looks like. And usually when you're in the boat, there's so many fears that are around our lives. The fear of feeling insecure. When I get out of the boat, you know, I'm going to feel insecure. I like my security. I like to know where everything is. I like everything in the boat. I like all the books in the boat. But you know, God is calling us out of our insecurity. How about this fear of loss of control? Oh, that's a biggie. Who knows, we like to be in control. I thank God that John at the beginning of the meeting talked about the Holy Spirit. that we have to rely on Holy Spirit. Why? Because we have to come out of our control into His control, into the control of the Holy Spirit, so that He can move in our lives. The fear of loss of control, because we want everything to be right, we want to know everything. But faith calls us to come out of the battle. Fear of the unknown. How about this one? The fear of making a fool of yourself. Can you imagine Peter? Can you imagine the fears that were going through Peter's mind? Jesus says, come, I want you to come out of the boat. I want you to walk on the water. He gives a command, says, come to me. Can you imagine Peter? He would have felt, well, what if I look stupid? Listen, sometimes in faith, we've got to get out of the boat. Yeah. We've got to trust God. It's not about what other people think. It's what God is calling us to, amen? How about this? The fear of failure. Anyone ever had the fear of failure? Do you know the fear of failure can cause us to go on self-destruct? Everything's good, and then for some reason we do something, and we don't know why we do it, but we do some stupid thing that causes us to go on self-destruct.
Yes.
Well, why did I do that? I want to tell you, it's a fear that may be breaking in our lives. It's a fear of failure. That if we do good, if we succeed, I don't feel comfortable. And so that fear of failure, so many fears can keep us inside, locked in to the boat where Jesus is calling us to launch out. Jesus is calling us to move forward. He's calling us to get out of the boat. And to move and to walk in faith. Amen. Number four. We've got to focus on Jesus. Here's what Peter did. You remember the story? He's actually walking on water. Don't give him a hard time because he falls. But I want to tell you, he walked in the supernatural. And God wants you to walk in the supernatural. God wants us to walk in the supernatural with God, in faith. And Peter's walking in faith on the water because Jesus said, come. And as he's walking on the water, focused on Jesus, his focus begins to change. And he begins to look at the sea. He begins to look at the water. And he begins to see the sea. And the Bible says that he gets that sinking feeling. Ever had that sinking feeling? Yeah. When you get your eyes off Jesus, your eyes onto yourself, your eyes onto the circumstances, instead of fixing your eyes on Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. We've got to keep looking to Jesus. Here's what the psalmist said. My heart is fixed on you. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 7 says this. We walk by faith and not by sight what we see. Our heart and our minds have to be fixed on Jesus. Hebrews tells us, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. You see, when we look at the circumstances around us, it will cause us to sink. It will cause us to fail. But we've got to keep our eyes on Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. This is my last point. Here's Peter. In this journey of faith, this journey where Peter walks in the supernatural, walks on the water, suddenly his eyes, his focus changes on that which is around him and he begins to sink. But here's what Peter does. He cries out, God, save me. God, save me. And he cries out to God. I want to tell you, folks, we've got to embrace our failures. And we've got to cry out to God. Well, you don't know, Pastor, I've called out to God before and I'm still in a mess. So keep calling out to God. He's your hope. well, I failed before. I don't know what to do. I failed in the past. So, but keep calling out to God, because He's your hope. He can save you. He can lift you out of the water. And the beautiful picture is of Jesus lifting him out of the water. It's called this. It's called grace. Thank God for grace. Who's pleased with me? That's why it's called amazing. It's amazing grace. Why? Because when we fall, He's what He does. When we cry out to God, He begins to lift us back up. And He causes us to walk in faith again. I want you to know something this morning. God wants you to walk in faith. Amen? He wants you to have a journey of faith. He wants to develop your faith so that you can walk in a different way in the supernatural like Peter did.